The entire world is changing and changing so fast that keeping pace is very difficult. What COVID-19 has done is going to change the way we do business, the way we live, the way we socially interact with each other is going to change forever. And when we analyze what is happening all around us, there are very profound changes, and these changes are going to impact us so deeply and permanently that tomorrow will be a different world. The private security industry in India has gone through the devastating changes. There has been downsizing, retrenchment, and close up. Many security service providers have wound up their operations. It is no more viable for them. And such upheaval which private security industry has gone through is changing the way we look at it. Security is the foremost requirement of any business, and probably this will be the last requirement of the business even when it is winding up. Those who need security are probably those who ill afford it. The most requirement of the very efficient security is for the startups, those who come to the business and are in the process of developing their business. They need security most. And they actually have very low budget. But on the other side, those who have been in the business, thriving, developing, progressing, and generating a lot of revenue are also, for the similar reasons, require security. So security is going to be for all the reasons, for all the seasons, whether it is boom time or gloom time, everyone needs security. I have interacted with many chiefs of security and found that they are to be put in two categories. Those who downsized their team, and there are those who increase their team size. Some security managers knew how to put logics and justifications and could actually increase their security manpower, highlighting with the management when vulnerabilities, when probabilities, and when criticality is increasing, security manpower must go up. But there are few chiefs of securities who, in absence of justification, right logics and reasoning, could not argue with the management, and when downsizing exercise started, they also were compelled to reduce their security manpower. And management today is seeing very closely that how we are managing the situation, how actually we are managing the security setup. Present normal is going to be the future. You manage in such a way during tough times that this is going to be the template for the future. Management is surely and certainly going to ask you, why should it come back to the normal complement of the security team? When everything is going up, criticality, vulnerability, and probability, you manage with the reduced manpower. And management is going to realize and argue for the downsizing, telling you upfront that this is the actual requirement of manpower, not the one with which you were previously operating, which would certainly seem to be inflated, unjustified. I have seen that during this period of lockdown, security chiefs were asked to manage many other functions besides the security. They were considered to be the responder in case of emergency. Under their business continuity plan or emergency plan, there were many teams which had earmarked responsibilities, and security was one of the team. Now when most of the team members of other teams are no more available at the site, in the factory or in the process plants or in your establishment, then as chief of security, you are asked and you also agree to do additional jobs. You become so much part of business continuity plan that tomorrow when things normalize, this present normal is going to be the future, and you will be more and more involved in business continuity plans. That is the change in the trend or change in trend which I foresee. Lockdown has also made security professionals think about remote monitoring, remote control. Though actually security management is a subject which cannot be done during lockdown condition from home. So work from home concept is not fully applicable. But as chiefs of security, in the hierarchy of the management, the actual groundwork is done by your other team members, and someday when you are not actually present on ground and you are at home, you would like to have better situational awareness. You like to have better integration of your security systems. So on one platform you would like to see how your CCTV surveillance is working. You want to see how many and what types of alarms are being generated, how these alarms are to be managed. You might like to see your patrolling team progressing and whether there are any infringement. You would like to see the operations at the gate, and this would develop a trend that in tomorrow's scenario of industrial security management, lot of emphasis is going to be paid on wearable gadgets, and we are going to have more and more Internet of Things. Similarly, we are going to have artificial intelligence very much deployed into industrial security management's gadgets and systems, and the whole integration of all of these. The clip of restriction, the imposition of lockdown and restriction on movements have impacted every operation. 90% of manpower was asked to stay put in their respective residences, but it was only the security function, the security team, which was expected and in fact asked to continue at their workplaces. It is a matter of satisfaction and pride that so far not even a single case is reported